Good afternoon. We're high above Maryland Stadium. Maryland takes it 34-7. I'm Wayne. Mason, Bruce, go with Bruce. What'd you see today as Maryland rolls over Rutgers on homecoming?
They took care of business. Rushing game was good as always. Don't think they had a turnover.
Actually, Kasim fumbled once. Rutgers recovered on 21.
Blindside. But they played solid, except, once again, you know, less than 100 yards passing.
Right.
That's the only downside to the game, but the rushing game was great. They won easy, 34-7. And I got to tell you something, guys. Rutgers is really, really weak. They're really weak.
Really, as we thought they were. Mason?
Yeah, Bruce kind of just explained the whole game. Rutgers is really bad in Maryland. They made their plays early in the game. Kasim didn't look too bad.
Well, he had three touchdown passes?
Three touchdown passes.
And they were all A passes. They were all on the money.
Right.
That was the bulk of the offense passing-wise.
Right. You got Tavon Jacobs on the right side, Tyon Fleet Davis down the middle, and Jayshon Jones in the left corner.
The last one was a phenomenal pass. I cannot believe he squeezed it in. And we should mention four interceptions. You know, Darnell Savage had two.
Savage, Cowart had one, and Trey Watson, who isn't the best cover guy, has another interception.
Yeah, so 34-7, they're 4-2. If you would have said before the season started, they'd be 4-2 after six games.
You take that.
You take
especially
that.
Especially with everything that was going on. Mason, for the first, 13 minutes of this game, it was nothing. It was a complete snooze fest. And then Maryland scores 17 points. Rutgers had the ball during that 2.5 plays. It was third down, they threw an interception. Maryland scored 17 points in about 3 minutes, changed the game. Is anybody here expecting this? We'll go with Mason first.
Well, the way the game started, no. But when we first looked at this game, obviously you expected Maryland to be up at least 17-0 before Rutgers scored. I mean, we're talking about a team here that's lost to Kansas by more than 20, to Buffalo by more than 20, hasn't even beaten an FBS team yet this season. So when you say that, yeah, I mean, Rutgers is just, they just aren't where you would want to be in the third year of a new coach.
All right, so yep. He's 7-24 now.
I was told by some of the Rutgers reporters, mm-hmm. He's back next year because, you know,
that's
why?
Good for us.
He's got a $10 million buyout,
oh,
and he's on the second year of probation or suspension, whatever it is, and they'll give him another year.
The 7-24 train keeps rolling. This post-game show, as always, we'd like to thank Meyer Consulting Engineers and Viener Four Gates. And we'll be back to talk about the day Byron Cowart had and some other defensive pluses after this commercial message.
Meyer Consulting Engineers. In the past 5 years, our organization has completed over 1,300 projects in the U.S. and abroad, including many structures at the University of Maryland. For structural engineering and materials testing and inspection, call Meyer Consulting Engineers.
We are back here in College Park, Maryland, 34, Rutgers 7. Byron Cowart had a heck of a day. A sack, a tackle for a loss, and his first interception here. Guys, can you tell the difference the defense was bringing it today?
Yeah, they just continuously they look stronger than they have in years past. And I just tried to pull up the stats, but they're not loaded on for defense yet. I mean, an interception, he was really hyped up after that. The sacks, they just, the only thing that I don't like is when they come off that edge, they just never seem to actually get the quarterback down. That's the only thing they can say negatively about this defense, but as far as improvement over the years, you can definitely see it on the defensive side as well.
My two guys to my right here are off to Iowa next week. Mason, give your dad the bad news about the Iowa quarterback today.
Well, Iowa's quarterback, Nathan Stanley, who Maryland will be facing next week, 20 for 30, over 300 yards, 6 touchdowns.
So you throw up this week. We'll get him next week. I mean, you get 2 interceptions by your safety, Savage, who's going to play in the pros. I mean, Brooks is a pro player. I think Trey Watson on defense is a pro player. And then you look at the guys who got out there for the first time for extended minutes, like Elliott linebacker, Egiwaba, and Chime.
Listen, the key next week is you can't go 3-and-out like we did today in the first quarter, or else the game will be over. You can't do that when you play a team like Iowa at Kinnick Stadium.
All right, we are looking for our guest, Jordan Steffy, who will be with us in a moment. We're going to take one more break here, and we'll be right back.
Terp Talk is brought to you by Viener Four Gates Consulting. Call Viener Four Gates for all of your IT needs. In the D.C. Baltimore area, you could reach us at 301-251-2900 or on the web at www.vinerforgates.com.
All right, segment three of the postgame show.
Look who's back, man.
It's Jordan Steffy. I told him I would have worn my number 19 jersey if I knew it was coming. So before we get in the game, you're doing a lot of stuff I see on Facebook all the time. What's going on with you?
We are so fortunate. Yeah, so the Children Deserve a Chance Foundation is the organization we started almost 10 years ago now. It's just crazy. And from that, we developed this program called Italo. And we are just working with young people, juniors and seniors in high school, as they explore their options after high school. Many of which are going to go to great schools like the University of Maryland.
Yay. Yay. All right, so like I said, how do you find you? Facebook?
Yep, so ataloprep.org.
Can you spell that?
A-T-T-O-L-L-O prep.org.
You're out of New Jersey? Or?
We're in Pennsylvania. We're focused in Pennsylvania right now, but we're looking to expand kind of throughout the region. So.
Tell us your impressions of the game today, and it's hard to say, isn't it?
It really is hard to say. I mean, Rutgers obviously is.
You would love the game like this.
Struggling a little bit. Yeah, they were a little different Rutgers when I was when we were playing them. But here's the thing about this team the whole season, right? They've had every reason in this world to not battle, to not fight, and they haven't taken that that excuse. They've come out each week, and I mean, you take a lumping at Michigan for sure, but they came out today. They played slow start and then got some points on the board. And I'm a big Kasim Hill fan. I think he's young. Mm-hmm. He's gonna continue to evolve, and I think they're gonna be competitive the rest of the season.
I'm glad you brought that up. As a quarterback, Kasim threw three touchdown passes tonight that were on the money. You know that.
Yeah.
He squeezed them in. They were perfect, and yet we can only gather 86 yards.
Mm-hmm.
How do you put those two things together? Is it just people forget he's really just a freshman in essence.
Exactly.
Still in what, his seventh game, or
We've got 4-2 this year. He played a game and a half last year.
Right. So it's his
seven and a half games. Yeah.
I mean, you, how long did it take you to get adjusted?
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, he's young. He's young. And then add on top of that everything else that's happening. It can't be easy. That being said, listen, you got to get victories any way that you can get them. They got it today in a convincing way. And, they're 4-2 right now, which I don't think many people would have
signed a contract for it.
Exactly.
We would have signed a contract for it.
So, I just think you got to take it week by week and, not overanalyze things at this point. He's very young, as you mentioned.
Right. Well, I've seen him playing a couple games where the passes sort of wobble on him.
Mm-hmm.
A couple of those throws today, I'm like, well, if the ball would have wobbled just a little bit, he would have had a couple more completions there.
Yep.
So suddenly he looks like he doesn't practice during the game.
Yep.
It's the first time I've seen him look like this since he's been back from an injury. He's throwing spirals on every play.
Yeah.
Jordan, it seemed to me that when he was on the move, he was kind of better.
Yeah.
In other words, when he got out of the pocket and rolled out, was that my imagination?
When you're moving, it really takes away the mental side of it. And as well as anybody that when you're playing that position, it's as much in your head as it is the physical side of it. And I think all of us could acknowledge he's young and he's hearing some things in other places as well. But I continue to believe in him. I know him. I know his family. They're great people. And my belief is that he'll just continue to battle. And we're going to be this year and years beyond, very, very happy that Kasim Hill is our quarterback.
All right, Wayne, I have to make a confession here.
I owe
this guy a couple of rounds of golf.
rounds of golf?
We never put it together, so you got his phone number. When spring comes,
there we go.
Do you ever get down?
Of course.
To Baltimore or whatever?
Yep.
All right.
So let's do it.
We will. Forgotten.
All right, well, the Terp Talk opener, in my case, or whatever we'll call it.
But you can tell out of the ball, can you?
You look like you've been working out a little bit.
Trying, although it's not nearly as easy as it was.
I'm losing. Dr. Steph, to get in the shape, I picked round. Probably was the wrong shape to pick.
You know, there's guys that you meet everything, and this is one guy here who knew was going to be a success.
Yeah,
maybe not as a professional quarterback.
Oh, absolutely.
But in the business world and everything else, you've proven us right. Maryland's proud of you, and welcome back for homecoming.
That means a lot. It's great to be back.
Okay, great. Well, thanks for being on. Of course, we'll do this again. Maryland rolls 34-7 on homecoming. Big takeaways. Defense kept Rutgers to about 51 yards when the ones were in, and the running game came back. Bruce, we'll see you tomorrow morning on
in the Nest, preview of the Ravens game against Tennessee, and we'll be on Terp Talk on Wednesday night.
And then on Saturday, I will be at Kinnick Stadium at Iowa, hoping to pick up that fifth win.
There we go.
So,
yeah. Go Terps.
Go Terps. And for Intern Mason, that's Jordan Steffy, Bruce Posner. I'm Wayne Viener. We will see you on the radio. Good afternoon.